is the best Christmas pageant ever, and I'm going to do it with the Herdmans too. After all, they raised their hands and nobody else did, and that's that. So Mother called the first rehearsal. Everybody quieted down right away for fear of missing something awful the Herdmans might do.
Who are the shepherds? Where did they come from?
What was the inn? Like, what's an inn?
It's like a motel where people go to spend the night.
Well, people, Jesus?
Honestly, Claude, Jesus wasn't even born yet. Mary and Joseph stayed there.
Yes, you else.
What happened first? Begin at the beginning.
The thing was, the Herdmans didn't know anything about the Christmas story. They knew that Christmas was Jesus' birthday, but everything else was news to them. The shepherds, the wise men, the star, the stable, the crowded inn. So Mother said she had better begin by reading the story out of the Bible. This was a pain in the neck for most of us because we knew the whole story backward and forward.
Joseph and Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child.
Pregnant!
I don't think it's very nice to say that Mary was pregnant.
But she was.
I'm not supposed to talk about things like that in church.
Tell her.
I better tell my mother.
Tell her what?
That your mother is talking about things like that in church.
I was pretty sure she would too, because she still wanted to be married, but there wasn't much I could do about it. As Mother told the story, one of the Herdmans would yell, "What's that?" whenever they didn't understand something.
So there wasn't enough room at the inn, not even for Jesus?
Well, no, nobody knew the baby was going to turn out to be Jesus.
You said Mary knew. Why didn't she tell everyone?
I would have told them. Boy, would I have told them. What was the matter with Joseph, him not telling them? Her pregnant and everything.
What was that? They laid the baby in the manger? Is that like a bed? Why would they have a bed in a barn?
That's just the point. They didn't have a bed in the barn, so they had to use whatever there was. What would you do if you had a new baby and no place to put the new baby in?
We put Gladys in a dresser drawer.
What?
Well, there you go. You didn't have a bed for Gladys, so you had to use something else. Joseph and Mary had to use a manger. A manger is a large wooden feeding trough for animals.
Hold up. What were the wadded up clothes?
The what?
You read about it. She wrapped him in wadded up clothes.
Swaddling clothes. Long ago, people used to wrap their babies up very tightly in big pieces of material so they couldn't move around. This made the babies feel comfortable and cozy.
So, why didn't Mary get to name the baby?
Joseph got the name of Imogene.
Joseph didn't name the baby either. God sent an angel to tell Mary what the baby's name should be.
I would have named him Bill. So what did the angel do? Just walk in and say, "Name the baby Jesus"?
Mother was in a hurry to finish, so she said, "Yes." But then, Alice Wendelkin had to open her big mouth.
I know what the angel said. She said, "Call him Wonderful Counselor, Everlasting God, Almighty Father, Prince of Peace."
I could have hit her.
OMG, you would have never gotten out of first grade if you had to say all that.
And so it went. Mother telling the story and explaining it to the Herdmans. They were really interested in Herod. When Mother said that he planned to put the baby Jesus to death, Imogene exclaimed,
OMG, he'd just been born and they're already out to kill him?
Yeah.
Don't make me put you back in the drawer.
I figured they were interested in Herod because they liked him. He was so mean, he could have been their ancestor, Herod Herdman. But I was wrong. They wanted somebody to beat him so they could beat up on him. I couldn't understand the Herdmans. You would have thought the Christmas story came right out of the police files. They got so involved in it, wanted a bloody ending to Herod, worried about Mary having her baby in the barn,